الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت، ذي العزة والجبروت، الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. أما بعد، يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and die not except on the state of Islam. For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, bestow upon us the gift to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. In a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, narrated by Abi Bakr, in this hadith describing a situation to which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed to Abi Bakr, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu entered the masjid. When he entered the masjid, he found the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam already in ruku', just to be in the ruku' and seeking two things: to not miss the rak'ah, and also to benefit to be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the first row. Then, as soon as he entered, he make his takbirah and he went to ruku', and then start to walk in a state of ruku' to join the line. After with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, زَادَكَ اللَّهُ حِرْصَى وَلَا تَعُدْ. In a beautiful hadith, described for us in a way how the believer need to live his life, and before that, put the right structure for his worship. And worship, what we're talking about, worship, not only his worship as the relation between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but every aspect in his life or her life need to be part of the structure of worship. So zadakallahu hirsan, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase your caring, your eagerness, your zeal to do such a thing. And this is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam making dua to Abi Bakr to teach us and to give us that the way of the education, to educate the believers and give them the right tarbiyah to know what to take and what not to take. So here, the Prophet ﷺ قَالَ زَادَكَ اللَّهُ حِرْسًا, which is mean like every believer need to increase the caring, the attention, the eagerness toward, hasten toward the way of Allah, hasten toward the ibadah, have your heart to be driven toward it. However, the Prophet ﷺ قَالَ لَا تَعُدْ, but don't do what you have done. So here we have two aspects: in coming to Allah, in intending to do any action with which you seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has the state of the heart which is going to be drive you, which is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, may Allah to increase you in such eagerness, in such care. But the other one, he said, don't do it, which is mean the way how to do it. Therefore, we have in the action, if we seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these two aspects: the aspect in the heart, which will be the drive toward what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pleases. And then the way how to do it. And the way how to do it, it's not what he has done is ruku'. So what he done is ruku' is right. He joined the first row, it's right. But subhanAllah, when you look at it, if you try to imagine the situation of a person walking in a state of ruku', it really does not represent the way of someone who's in relation with Allah, connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is some defect into the image. So the image, as a believer, we do not actually neglect the image. The image, it is actually a reflection of what you have inside, which is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he ordered us to be clean and pure. Purity in the heart reflected in the purity and the cleanliness of the appearance. So the way that Abi Bakr, the way of Abi Bakr, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't do it. Don't do it. So you say, how can we understand such a thing? It is about the knowledge of the laws of the Sharia, to know what should we do when you enter the masjid. Should they pray the sunnah, tahiyyat al-masjid, and before, or should I join the imam and do it? It's not actually the question at all. It's not. It's something else that we need to be careful about, and we need to be caring about. Because when you come to act in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this example in the prayer, what are you seeking in the prayer? What is your purpose of your prayer? You're being driven to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, this is a great gift. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those who do not have it or striving to have it, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide us this hirs, this eagerness. Because such eagerness, everyone in this planet Earth, as a human being, they have it. But it becomes something commanded, recommended, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His messenger, for the believer, when you seek and use it for what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But everyone else have it. For the thing, for the goal that they want to achieve in their own dunya. As a matter of fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blamed and caused to disgrace the people. They were from the Yahud, from the children, Bani Israel. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, قَالَ وَلَتَجِدَنَّهُمْ أَحْرَصَ النَّاسِ عَلَى حَيَاتِ. You'll find them the most eager, the most caring, the most attached to life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, He didn't say to the life, He said to life, which is any life. Just to survive, to live, to eat, sleep, and that's it. If there is enjoyment or there is not, we want to live. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَتَجِدَنَّهُمْ أَحْرَصَ النَّاسِ عَلَى حَيَاتٍ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا. So here Allah blaming such a people to hold on life without a purpose, to hold on life just to want to be immortal, or you want to live for eternity in this life. And many of those who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He said in the ayah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring them to evidence and call them to reflect and think. He said, قال, if they will live 1,000 years, living 1,000 years is going to help them to be saved from hellfire? No, it's not. Therefore, this type of hirs is blamed. This type of hirs must be rejected by the believer. If not, it's going to lead us to the full corruption and to ruining ourselves. Then the drive that everyone has, you find this drive for people to build their career, you find this drive for people to make money. This is the hirs, the caring, the attention, that eagerness to do things for the sake of Allah. It is required, it is obligated for those who really want to reach, and achieve the goals which is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, if we neglect the way to do it, that when we're going to lose the touch, that when we're going to lose, and miss the true goal and the true intent. Because, for example, the case we take for the Sahabi Abu Bakr, if someone will rush to the prayer, as example, but imagine this is for, it will apply for every action in our life. If you rush a person to do something, come into the prayer, say, why you are rushing? He said, I want to get, for example, to reach the first or catch the first rak'ah. Okay, so when you catch the first rak'ah, you are seeking the reward. He said, yes, alhamdulillah, I want the full reward. He said, are you thinking of the reward or are you thinking of the connection? Because you are missing something so great here, because if you miss the connection, you're not going to get the reward anyway. Even you are present before even an hour in the prayer, but you are totally distracted and you're not into the prayer and your mind, it's not with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then where's the reward that you're going to get? So here, the way when someone will rush to do something without reflecting and thinking, he is missing that part, which is the way how to initiate, how to build this action. So we should not say performing action, we need to think about building a whole action. So the whole action, it has the drive, the hirs, and the way how we're going to do it. In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ described for us such a thing to give us that right tarbiyah, those right elements to help us build our life within this structure. قَالَ إِذَا سَمَعْتُمْ الْإِقَامَةَ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ الْإِقَامَةَ فَمْشُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ وَعَلَيْكُمُ السَّكِينَةَ وَالْوَقَارِ. If you listen the call to prayer or the iqamah to start the prayer, then come to the prayer, walk to the prayer, and having on you calmness and solemnity, seriousness, to be serious. You have that feel of dignity, that feel of seriousness. As Allah subhanahu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qala sakina. So you have to be quiet and calm. Why? Because you're going to meet the King of the Kings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not about to get to the prayer first here. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling you walk. In walking, you're going to keep that calmness. in walking, you're going to develop that solemnity that you need for the prayer. قال, and then the Prophet ﷺ said, whatever you have, you know, join the prayer, you pray with the imam, you know, the rak'ah that you have, that he has to pray or remaining to the imam, and then you finish your prayer on your own. So here, the moral of the hadith here, that the Prophet ﷺ describing for us a situation in all which it need to be governing all the action of your life. There is the hirs, and there is the sakina, the calmness, the seriousness, the way how you build and initiate and perform this action. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the salah, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, when you walk to the salah, you are rewarded. When you sit waiting in the salah, you are in salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who's waiting in salah, he's indeed in salah. And when you start the salah, the pillar that is the core of the whole salah is calmness, which is al-itma'nan, to take your time. So the itma'nan, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaching the person who didn't know how to pray, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, go and repeat your prayer. He prayed like so fast, he came back, he told him, go back. And the third time he said, Ya Rasulullah, this is all what I know, please teach me. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you go to the prayer, when you go to ruku', itma'inna raki'ah, stay still in ruku'. That's the itma'inna, that time. That time to feel the connection, that time to feel that subhanallah, calmness, solemnity. You are with who? With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, as a believer, we need to think in our life to have this hirs, the drive. So how can we balance between them? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِذَا نُودِيَ لَصَلَاتِ مِنْ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ فَسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. When the call of the prayer of the Jumu'ah is heard, then hasten to the remembrance of Allah. So he say, how can I hasten? Allah told me to hasten, and I have to walk in full calmness and solemnity. So I cannot run. So subhanAllah, how to understand it is your heart, subhanAllah, goes to Allah as fast as you seeing a bird flying, you know, with all his wings, with all his effort. That's your heart travel to Allah with such, you know, hasty. And to be, subhanAllah, hasting to Allah. But when it comes to your situation, the way how you're going to do it, you have to preserve that dignity, you have to preserve that calmness, and that is the soul of the worship, that is the soul of the ibadah, that what would make you to have someone, a believer who had the khushu'. So this balance that the Prophet ﷺ is teaching us, we are required to have it in every aspect in our life. Why? Because if you miss that part, if you miss the way how to do it, we're going to miss the thamra, the result of the purpose, of the action. If you don't do that, then you're not going to benefit of the salah. The salah is going to give you not only the ajr that you're seeking, the ajr will be provided to you by Allah, but the salah is going to help you to change. It's going to improve your moral. It's going to improve you, your every aspect into your life is going to be improved by the salah. You're going to have more patience. It's going to prohibit you from doing ill things. So this is the salah. The salah will not have this effect that everyone need to think about, need to have it as a purpose, when every time you establish the prayer will not be possible if we do not have this way how to do it. We call it hay'ah. And the hay'ah is not only the knowledge how to do, how to pray, but it's the state of the heart, the state of the mind, the state that you are going to have a great fulfilling, a great trust to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This balance, dear brother, respected sister, is required, as I said, in every aspect in our life. In fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, that ta'anni, patience, is from Allah. Ta'anni, it's not truly, fully patience, but to take your time to reflect before you act. You build the element of the action, so when you perform the action, you perform it in the way that is helping you to fulfill the objective into the action, sought into the action. You want from the salah to feel peace. Then to feel peace, you have to do, you have to implement these steps. You want the salat to increase you in knowledge, increase you in patience, increase you in connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you have to do these steps. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالَ أَتَّأَنِّ مِنَ اللَّهُ وَالْعَجَلَةُ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. Patient and taking time and reflecting before to act, it is from Allah. It's a gift from Allah. To be hasty, it is from the shaitan, from the devil. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he received the Quran, he used to be, subhanAllah, to be hasty. He want to memorize it by fear that he will not be able to remember it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا تهجل بالقرآن. Do not be hasty in receiving the Quran. We're going to take care of that. وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا أَنْ أُسَيَّ Allah, increase me in knowledge. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we have it in the example of the salah, even the example in seeking knowledge for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is actually the defect if we are hasty in doing things? The defect that I have said, you do not seek indeed to achieve the purpose of the action. You become seeking just to do the action. I want just to pray. I'm just to read the Quran, just to get some knowledge, just to fulfill this, you know, transaction. But there is no heart behind it. There is no soul in it. So when someone is hasty, he's do it, and then subhanAllah, he goes, you know, just forget about that. So the ways, the mean is that you have to invest in that by having that khushu'. That is what it gives for the action is structure. What is give for the action, its meaning. What is give for that action, the help of Allah to you. Because when you think about getting to the prayer, you're going to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So think of Allah, do not think about how you're going to do the prayer. It's like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you trust in Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to secure the Quran in your heart. But if I'm going to rely on myself, I'm going to forget that I need to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to be hasty and lose the khushu', lose the focus, is going to have me to shift. Instead of relying on Allah, I'm going to be relying on myself. And then I will lose touch of that action. And by losing touch of the action, later on I'm going to lose touch with my faith, with my heart. So you see, that eagerness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we hope and we ask Allah and we supplicate Allah to give it, to pour it in our heart, to seek His pleasure. We need with it this place or this structure of khushu', of focus, of calmness, of seriousness. As I have told you, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Al-Ashaj ibn Qais, when they came to visit the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everyone from his delegation, they went, rushed to meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Him, he didn't go. He took his time, he took his shower, he put his clothes, and afterward he went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Prophet saw him, he said, "Qala, you have two characteristics beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fika khaslatayn yuhibbuhum Allah." He's so happy. What are these khaslatayn? What are these two characteristics? They are al-anat wal-hilm, forbearing and patience. Take your time before your act. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Ibrahim alayhi salam a forbearing son, ready to subhanAllah to forbear and to bear all these difficulties. So as soon as Ibrahim opened for him and told him about this big message, scary, terrifying, that I'm going to kill you, subhanAllah, قَالَ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. This is the khushu'. So if someone look for the focus and the devotion in his salah, he has to look at in all his action of his life. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed in the salah, we showed in inquiring knowledge and in every aspect of your life. Then how someone to really build this structure within ourselves, to have that drive, to fly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but to keep this calmness and seriousness which actually reflect or develop our khushu' to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is easy if you just hope for it, if you just ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it. Why? Because everything comes from how much you love Allah, how much you care about Allah, how much you care about your religion, how much you care about your path. If we do not care about our path, then that eagerness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to every human being, we're going to use it for something else. If you care about the deen of Allah, if you care about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you in the Quran, if you care about meeting Allah, if you love to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help you to have the hirs and help you to have this hay'ah, this khushu'ah, this way how to implement it and how to perform the action so you get benefit of the purpose of the action. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Ibn Abbas, he said, and this is the answer, he said, be mindful of Allah. Subhanallah, being mindful of Allah, it's very easy, wallah. Being mindful of Allah is not going to take anything of your time. You driving, being mindful of Allah. You work, being mindful of Allah. What it means? Allah is in your mind. Then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your mind is going to help you to have that drive, and is going to help you in every action that you're going to do, you do it seeking the pleasure of Allah. You will elevate it, you will perform it, you will build it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the example, how to take every action and build it, and have it to grow like a strong tree. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the example of the tree, right? The example of the tree that is well-rooted and very high. So well-rooted, that is your relation with Allah. And very high goes by fulfilling the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then provide you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all its fruits. So here, by being mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you take care of your action. So every action you do, it's either when it comes to your study, when it comes taking care of your children, or taking care of your parents, or be caring of others, it's all of it, subhanAllah, think of it as a tree. You're going to plant a tree. And this tree needs that hirs, that eagerness, and what need that khushu', that way of eagerness, that way of seriousness, that way of calmness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the example of Musa alayhi salam. He was hastened to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what happened? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why are you hasty to come to me? He said, Ya Allah, he told him, what about your people? He said, they are behind me, and I came to you. I've been coming to you fast, Ya Allah, for you to be pleased. He said, indeed, your people, they've been going through a big fitna. They changed their religion. They are worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you see, subhanAllah, it don't put our action within this structure of patience, structure of calmness, structure of what we call khushu', then we will not be able to take advantage of our action. For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instill in our heart khushu' and help us to have the hirs, but with the hirs, the way how to accomplish the action to benefit of its purpose. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. Studying the lives of the prophets will help us to understand such a great structure with which all the prophets they lived by. In the hadith of Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنه, and Ibn Abbas, he heard this hadith when he was 6 years old. احفظ الله يحفظك واجعل الله تجاهك. And the rest of the hadith is long and is one of the greatest ahadith that give you the firmness and the understanding of your own creed. But just from the beginning of the hadith that what we need in this talk, inshallah, as I have mentioned, to be just mindful of Allah. Subhanallah, there is no single person in this life, but they're always mindful of something. People always mindful of making money. Always think about it. Thinking about always people listen, what the next tune that they're going to listen, what the next thing that they're going to do. So they always have something in their mind. If you do, subhanAllah, be mindful of Allah. What is going to happen if you look at Ibrahim alayhi salam? Being mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have that eagerness and have the tuma'nina, that tranquility which is that focus to be with Allah in every aspect in your life. And it does not take any time from you. It does not you know, force you to be in seclusion. No, you work, you go, you shop, you do everything. But mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is going to happen? You're going to have patience before the trial befall on you. You're going to have contentment before the decree befall on you. You're going to have the friend to help you before getting into your journey. Why? Because when you are in this situation, Allah provides you the sabr. Like exactly Ibrahim, he already has the sabr. Why? Because he's already mindful of Allah, had the hirs and had the khushu. Then when the trial of even being thrown in the fire, subhanAllah, he was ready. Not ready that he won't be thrown in the fire, but ready to face it. Why? Because he already has the sabr. He already has the rida. Whatever is going to be befall on me, I already have the rida. Like the Prophet ﷺ said, Ya Allah, whatever happened to me, by throwing rocks on me, by causing me to bleed and wounding me, if it's not the result of your wrath, then I don't mind. Why, subhanAllah, this is the structure of the believer that we need. So you see the Prophet ﷺ, from you walking to the prayer, teaching you how to be a fortress of security, teaching you how to be a strong tree, that it will stand against the winds and against the storms. And still when you look at it, it's beautiful with all its leaves. That's the believer. That's the believer. And this is, subhanAllah, it only comes from one point, which is your relation with Allah. Ask yourself how much you love Allah. And that's it, we're going to be your help, your guide, to find this element, to build the structure, who's going to give you this fortress of security and build for you this strong tree that always look beautiful and challenge all the storms around, because it is helped by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I finish with the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hadith of the Prophet teaching us how to manage everything you have and how to manage your time in relation with the love of Allah is an amazing hadith, which is really built your relation and connection to Allah and give you the right tarbiyah. He said, Ya Allah, urzuqni hubbak. Allahumma urzuqni hubbak. Oh Allah, bestow upon me the gift of your love. The dear brother and respected sister, if you say, Ya Allah, you know, you love Allah, have you ever asked Allah to give you that gift for Allah to love you? Allahumma urzuqni hubbak. وَحُبَّ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ يَنْفَعُنِي حُبُّهُ عِنْدَكَ. And the love of everything, from people, from things, that my love to it will help me in getting closer to you, Ya Allah. In this, which is mean, the Quran get me closer to you, Ya Allah, make it dear to me. The Salat make you closer to you, Ya Allah, make it dear to me. And then, the most amazing is the last part of the hadith. He said, Allahumma wama razaqtani mimma uhib faj'alhu quwwatan li fima tuhib. Oh Allah, whatever you have bestow upon me of thing I love. You give me money, yes, Ya Allah, I love. But Ya Allah, make it to be a strength for me in what you pleases you. Ya Allah, you gave me children. I love my children. Ya Allah, make my children to be a strength to me, to get your pleasure. Ya Allah, you give me business that I love. Ya Allah, make this business to be an increase of strength and empowerment to me to get closer to you. You see, subhanAllah, you live the life that you love, but yet serving Allah, and Allah aid you more. And then the last part he said, قَالَ اللَّهُمَّ مَا زَوَيْتَ عَنِّي مِمَّا أُحِبْ. Ya Allah, there are things that I love that you didn't answer me when I ask you, Ya Allah, give it to me. You didn't give it to me. There is things that I love and you took them away from me. There is dear ones I lost. They're gone. So subhanAllah, look the beautiful management of time that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam associated to you with the love of Allah. He said, Ya Allah, whatever you didn't give me or take away from me, things that I love, then make the time that I was going to devote for those things to be a time devoted to you, Ya Allah. This hadith, if we say it with sincerity, seriousness, and true solemnity, it will help you to have that hirs and have to have that khushu', that structure who's going to help you build that fortress. And if you have that fortress, you know what it means? You are the most happy person on earth. Because no trial will make you sad. You already have the patience. No decree is going to destroy you because you already have contentment. And no path that is going to be lonely for you because you already have the friend. فَمَيْ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى increase us in eagerness, hirs, and increase us in knowledge, and increase us in khushu', and provide us this calmness and itma'nan in every aspect of our life. اللهم زدنا علما اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين اللهم زدنا حرصا يا أرحم الراحمين فيما يرضيك عنا اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من يحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إلى حبك اللهم وما رزقتنا مما نحب فاجعله قوة لنا فيما تحب اللهم ما زويت عنا مما نحب فاجعله فراغا لنا فيما تحب برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله
الله أكبر الله